you guys have seen what a basement apartment looks like here in Canada, I would like to share with you guys some pros and cons of life in a basement and also a few things that you should look for when you are looking for a basement apartment for yourself.
You turned toward me and looked so weak. I've never seen you with such tired eyes. And everything we said we'd be, we just traded for a suit coat and a tie.
So beginning with the positive points first, the first is of course the affordability. You can easily find a basement apartment, actually a two-bedroom basement apartment between a rental range of $1,000 to $1,300 in the GTA. You also get more space for the same amount of money. For example, if you look for a two-bedroom apartment, it would be quite expensive than a two-bedroom basement apartment. So you'll save roughly around $500 to $600 just by choosing a basement apartment rather than an apartment or a condo. It is also a very good option for the single immigrants who might be living in a shared space in an apartment and are okay to spend a few more dollars to get an independent space for themselves. I have heard that some of the shared single rooms in Toronto are as expensive as the one bedroom apartments in the suburbs. It is also a very good option for people who might be sharing the living space in an apartment or a condo and do not mind shelling a few extra dollars to get their private independent space. Another very important positive point with the basement apartments that is especially of importance to new immigrants is that the lease conditions are usually very flexible for the basement apartments as compared to the apartments. When you're new here in Canada, you do not have a settled job, you might not have a job offer when you will be looking for the basement apartments and you will not be having your credit history most certainly. So it might be difficult for you to get a lease for an apartment because they have more stringent qualifying conditions, but you can easily find a basement apartment for yourself if you can convince the landlords that you will be paying rent on time. Another important thing to consider is that you have less financial liabilities in a basement apartment. You generally do not have to pay any kind of maintenance fee that you might have to pay in a condo. All the condos have a condo fee. In the basement apartments, usually all the utilities are covered in your rent, so it's all inclusive and it avoids extra expense. Now, beginning with the negative points of life in a basement, and the first thing is that the basements are too noisy. Now the houses here in Canada are not made or built like they're built in India or in Asia with brick and mortar. They are generally made of wood or some similar substance. So it is very noisy in the basement. No matter how cautious or mindful your landlords are, you're still going to hear every single step that they take in their house, and it can be pretty irritating at times. The second most important negative point of life in a basement is that it can get pretty depressing at times. You have little to no contact with the outside world. We are lucky that we have at least a few windows here through which light can enter. There are some basements that we saw that did not have pretty big windows. There was no light, there was no fresh air coming in, and you could not see anything outside. So it gets very, very depressing if you have to be in the basement for the whole day. Especially if you come here in winters like we came, you have little to no possibility of moving outside every single day. And especially if you are coming with a kid and you have to spend most of your time inside. And it gets very, very tough if you cannot see one thing outside. If you move out, there is fresh air. You can see such beautiful surroundings out you, and it is so uplifting. But inside a basement, you can just see the four walls of the room, and that is very, very depressing at times. Another very important thing is that the basements are usually cooler than the rest of the house, and you do not have temperature control in your hands. So if you're feeling cold, you can do nothing about it. Our landlords are pretty nice, so it's been quite a time that we've requested them to raise the temperatures because we were literally shivering in the basement. There is another very major thing that I've seen in a lot of basement apartments, especially the older ones. We don't face that issue as much, and that is of a smell. Basement apartments are usually more damp and more prone to moisture retention than the rest of the house because there is literally no ventilation. It is especially a problem in the basements with the carpet that there is a lot of smell and also sometimes molds. Another negative thing that I have personally felt is that I started to have a lot more headaches because I spent more time inside the house while Asmara and Rohan are both outside the house for most of the time. I started to have a lot of headaches. I don't know. I tried to research that it might be due to the basement, and I think the heat and the lack of ventilation actually leads to that. Another major issue that we are facing here in the basement is the network problem. Our phones do not work properly in the basement apartment, and every time we have to rush out to talk on the phone. So that is one major issue. Now, if you think the pros outweigh the cons of life in a basement, then you should look for a basement apartment for yourself. Some of the tips to consider while looking for a basement are: prefer a walkout basement with a separate entrance over the walk-in basement. You will have more privacy as you will have a separate entrance and also ease of access. Also, try to look for newer basements. You would have much lesser issues as compared to old basements. The newer basement usually have higher ceilings, have more and bigger windows allowing more light and fresh air, and they are fresher and less susceptible to mold and dampness. Most of the houses have their furnace and the hot water tanks installed in the basements. Do ask your landlord if they have a separate access to that furnace room, or they would need an access through the basement apartment because that can affect your privacy. Also, a few other points to check are the parking slots. Ask the landlord how many of them are available if you have more than one car. Carpeted basements are never a good idea. I have seen a lot of carpeted basements. They have a lot of problem with smell and molds. Ask the landlords if all the basic utilities like hydro and Wi-Fi and everything are included in your rent or they are separate. If they're not included, then what's the charge? Try to ask the landlord in advance that what kind of responsibilities will you share with the landlord. For example, in winters you have to clear snow, or in summers you have to cut the grass. So just try to ask them what is the arrangement like. Another major thing you should always check is the smoking habits. If you are a smoker and the landlord is a non-smoker, or vice versa, it can be a big problem because the smoke travels through the entire house through the vents. Another final tip is that always try to get a sense of the vibe that you're getting from the landlords, because you are kind of sharing your living space with your landlords. They are going to be practically living with you every single day. So if you're not getting a good vibe from them, or you don't feel that you would get along with them very easily, don't go for that basement apartment. Do hit the like button if you like the video, and do not forget to subscribe to the channel. You can also follow us on our Facebook page, Right Turn to Canada, and on our Instagram handle, Right Turn to Canada. So until I see you next time, bye bye and take care.